All right, got a lot to say and try to get in here quick. I don't really like making long videos. I wrote a few things down real quickly on, I got two video responses so far. On the first one, no spaces at all or whatever it is. The divine command theory, and you say that genocide was part of religion, or however you want to say it, whatever. For one, there was stoning on the Sabbath day because people were working or whatever happened. That was the Old Testament. Most Christians believe, other than maybe Jewish facts or whatever, most Christians believe that we're in the New Testament era. The Old Testament still applies, but is not, a lot of the things aren't taken into the New Testament. In fact, Jesus even said some things about the Sabbath. I'm not really going to go into that, but I just wanted to bring that point up. And, you know, because I base right and wrong on religion, I don't understand how that makes me wrong. How me basing, I mean, if you do nothing more but use the Bible as a guidebook, if you simply read it and just simply follow the rules that are set in there, it would still help you have a healthier life, a happier life. Maybe that's my own view. I mean, that is my own views. Maybe that's, you know, something that you completely whatever. I didn't mean that atheists were never in slavery. That wasn't what I meant by when I said something about, I was just talking about how recent something of that magnitude has happened to a particular group of people, and so I could see why they could still have hatred or bad feelings towards another group of people. I mean, there's been persecution of Christians throughout, I mean, the years. I mean, my goodness, it, obviously you probably know about that. The blasphemy challenge, I was going to touch on that a little bit. I think that it was, I don't think that there's any freedom coming with blaspheming. I think that, you know, you're saying freedom or whatever, but it also required a lot of pushing. It also required, you know, well, you're not a strong atheist if you don't do this, you're only a weak atheist, or whatever. I think that there was a bit of that in there also. Oh yeah, and Pete Stark is a congressman who said that he was an atheist. That's pretty much all I wanted to say to you. I also made a bad, very bad generalization about atheists when I said, that it would darken my views, and that, they all seem to be hateful, blah, 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 blah. That is a very bad generalization. I'm, you know, sorry for generalizing and putting every atheist into one group, which obviously is not the case. Kalin666, I really liked your video. It was actually helpful, and actually there was some good points in it. I enjoyed it a lot more than I did the other video, because you didn't tell me how stupid I was in the other one, you know. I just, you know, I really just want to understand. That's what I'm here for, and that's what I got into the debate for. Me personally, my personal beliefs is that I would rather believe in God and be wrong than to not believe in God and be wrong. I mean, the consequences are detrimental. They're a lot worse if you flip it around and you're wrong as an atheist than if I'm wrong as a Christian. You know, I touched on it a little bit, saying that, you know, an afterlife has given me a little bit more of an understanding of life and how it makes me you know, love other people and really try to not offend anybody, try to do good. I still feel that way. I know that No Spaces At All or whatever said that that's a horrible reason to be good to people, but I don't know. I read a comment that Deconverted said about Christianity was nothing more than a death cult. Yes, Christians do believe that God's coming back, and Christians do believe that there will possibly be a destruction of the earth, but I can't see in any way how that constitutes a death cult. When I think of a death cult, it would be more of like a mass suicide or something of that nature, and that just doesn't happen in actual Christianity. I know I won't be able to convince any atheist to believe what I believe, and I'm not trying to do that, and I know that no atheist will be able to convince me to become an atheist. So, I think you're right a little bit about the negative spin that I put on atheist, Kalin. Probably stems from my Christianity, from being raised as a Christian, and the first church that I went to probably stems from that, and, you know, kind of sorry about that. The blasphemy challenge, though, I just really couldn't get over that. David Mills using the Bible to scrape up dog crap and all that, that was just, it was highly offensive to me because that is my sacred scroll or my guidebook or whatever else you want to call it. That is my means to my religion. That is my sacred scroll, my sacred book, whatever. So that really just highly offended me because of that. Pretty much, you know, I think that everybody has had a lot of valid points. Together for Peace's new video, I'm just along the same lines. I just want to learn. So if you have anything else to add, you know, you're more than welcome to take it.